and it didn't really seem to make a big difference. Anyway, let's actually begin. Let's make a beginning. Beginning is always the hardest. So I need to get a roundabout in. So let's do this. Do I want to do... Yeah, see, I can't build anything else anyway yet. Or can I? I'm going to four lane in. Yeah, I can't build like any... Music still seems way too loud to me. Anyway, exciting times. It's always a bit like starting, you know? It's like, how do you start with these things? It's going to be really good. Once we get cracking, it's going to be good. Okay, let's begin. So I need to put a roundabout up here. And then we'll start working. I don't know what this first town is really going to be, the purpose of this first town will be. Do you know something I have noticed, though? Is that since they did the most recent update, this is going to be one of my classic roundabouts. Oh, it's okay, actually. That's not bad for a freestyle roundabout. Right, now I just need to do the off-ramps. Do a one lane, or I think just two lane on and off. I thought that you could actually build like highways still. So we've got six lane, but no highways yet. I think because you have to sort of get into it. You can have a three lane one way, so I may as well just bang that in. We'll just do these quite straightforward. Right, there we go. And I will turn off traffic lights right there. Cool, awesome. Alright, so that's going to enable them to come in, and then we just need to get a road down here. The music still sounds a little loud for me, guys, but maybe turn down the volume on your headset compared to your voice. It doesn't seem too loud. Yeah, I have adjusted it a little bit right now, but anyway, right, so I think I want my first town to actually be sort of down here, because you always want to build it kind of close to the water to start with, so you can get your resources without having to put tons of pipelines in. So I'm going to build a curving road, but I normally would build a six lane, but on this one, I don't think I'm going to do that. So let me just build a road straight out like here. Space already occupied? What? Why is that space already occupied? Yeah, see, it's fine. Okay. I'm going to come down here. Yeah. And I think... maybe at this point we can kind of split off in two directions. Couldn't you just turn the game volume down in window? Yeah, could do that. But it was more that the only sound that was too loud was the music. Everything else is fine, you see. Right, as usual, I'm going to start to begin with a very basic grid, but I can adjust that later. Get some nice shoreline houses happening. Right, that'll be our basic start point for this. I don't even know what we're going to name the whole town and community and everything. We need to get some services in. We're going to have to start the zoning, so let's do this. Now again, don't want to like build too much too quick, because that's a surefire way for things to go wrong. Let me just start here, maybe. Okay. We'll just start this. Okay, we're going to need water, and we're going to need sewage. So we're going to place this here, and we're going to place our sewage plant, I guess... This is also going to be problematic because of rivers and stuff. We'll place that one there for now. We're going to need power. What is this? Offshore wind turbine. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, so you can actually place this off. But it doesn't produce actually any more power than on land. And we've got some good space right here. The music seems to be quite consistent. I have a feeling like I could actually do without the music at all, to be honest. Right, I'm going to have to link these two together. And then I'm going to have to link right the way down here. Houses are starting to be built. I'm actually going to build this kind of like offshore here. Put that in there. Right. So that's everything powered up. Now they're going to need water, so we have to connect our pipelines. So I'm pretty excited about this map. I think the beginning is going to be fairly straightforward, but then as we go along, that's where it's going to get really interesting. I'm trying to do my standard not doing pipes very well. Okay, there we go. Why is there no mod to remove the clicking when adding roads? Well, there is actually, in my ambient sounds. Oh, the houses look nicely snowed in. I've added a load more building models into the game, so we should have some nice more variation there. Darth Sniper, how you doing, buddy? Good to see you, haven't seen you for a while. Chicken as well, Domo as well, Cicetta, Sky first. We've got loads of new and old people in tonight. Right, we'll keep expanding this, because now once we've got some power in, we can afford to expand further without it having a really detrimental impact. And that music is winding me up a little bit, I have to say. The clicking as well, I should be able to adjust this basically, because in the ambient sounds tuner, you can go into here and have miscellaneous, and you can do stuff like placement, building, roads, and you can see that the sound is down. I can turn that down a bit further, so you can actually adjust. You can barely see those cursors, but you can do things like clicks and road drawer. Okay, so I can turn the road drawer down about half. Actually, I think this is actually, so placement of roads. There we go. So I've turned down road drawer by half. So that should actually adjust that a little bit. This in-game audio, I mean, look, the audio music is toned down so much, I can't believe that the music is still so loud when I've turned it down so much. The music seems to be almost unaffected. I think it's better now, but the music seems to be, like, it's still very present for 3%. I can't believe it's so quiet. Right, so we're rolling. Let's speed things up a bit. So I'm going to increase the time by to full speed. God, it's still quite loud. It's really odd. Right, we'll paste in some shops here as well. And we'll start properly expanding the community a bit more into this valley here. Now, it's kind of going on a very basic sort of squarish template, which I know you guys know is not particularly common for me, but it's just the beginning. And then we'll start. Once we've got a bit more stuff in, we'll really bounce it up. I missed that one. Yaris, 6 months. 6 months in a row. Thank you, Yaris. Thanks for supporting me all this time, man. I really appreciate it. Yes. Honor Guard Yaris. Oh, yeah, that's a good point. I did update the Donation Brotherhood, so you can check that out there as well. Right, we've got a good start for the community. Sun is going down in the hills. We need to get some industry happening. The question is where? Now, this is where it really gets a little tricky, is that unlike most of the time, I can't put the industry very, very, very far away from everything because we're on such a small peninsula and I don't have loads and loads of money to spend. I got to do this kind of quickly. So I'm really going to have to put in like a small industrial park over here and keep it away from the town. So I'm actually going to do that. So I'm going to put in like a little industrial space here. And we'll just roll this down here. Okay. Roll that in. Okay, and then I'm going to have another little road come out and over this way. I'm going to have to probably... Perfect, like that. And then we're going to need another road which goes straight the way across here, which I'm going to actually sort of blend down to the river. And this will be obviously for workers to connect to... industrial park. So that's actually quite a nice little setup to start with. But we need to get some industrial stuff in there quickly so that we can get some jobs happening. So let's do that. Bang, 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 bang. And we're going to need some power. But hopefully I can get away with, yeah, look, I'll just put one of my, this thing. So this is a mod. It's a great mod. This is a power relay. This is definitely an essential mod. The power relay allows you to put in like a little block like this and run cables across a space without actually having to use power lines. So I can just bang that in there. Bridges the gap, and it saves me having to build more power lines. I do need to add water services for these guys, so we'll just bang that in, and that's that done. Wet Paint Gaming, looting any chance of a Patreon Plaza on this map, or similar for those of us who support you by other means, please. That's a really good idea, Wet Paint. That's a really good idea. I think I should just do that for, yeah, like everyone who supports me on Patreon. I think that's a really good idea. Thanks for that one, Wet Paint. Green says, in Luton City, the roads are 100% clear of snow, even during the winter. Yeah, because I just have like the best people working. Although it's getting pretty snow. You can see, guys, like it's actually snowing now. You see the nice blur as well, like the kind of nice snowingness when you're moving around here. A lot of the industrial buildings are looking quite good as well, because I've got a good mix of some of the new industrial stuff as well. I actually feel like industrial stuff should be a bit more like just sort of units of buildings, not necessarily always pollution spewing factories and stuff. Confluence, proper terminology for this type of road design is lutiny. Yeah, I know, it's 100% right. Oh dear. Yaris, can't afford more than this. Spent it today, so buy to me. Don't worry, Yaris. Every little bit, man, is so welcome. So thank you very much indeed. You're throwing it all at Oshi. That's the trouble. Throwing it all at Oshi right there. Yeah, don't jinx the roads. Got to have your Mr. Plow on. Why is there not a Mr. Plow thing anyway? I'm liking the town, though. Look at the town when it's all snowy. That's looking good. One thing I wish, though, was that I hadn't put my... my grid square axis so close. I think my next space to open up will actually be perhaps to the north, but we'll see what happens. Anyway, we've fulfilled some of our basic stuff. We need to get more people into the town, and so we really need to bang on with that. So let's do this. So we'll start creating some proper little residential neighborhoods here, and we can really drive forward with the town now. So we're going to need to have like heating supplies and so on, but apparently we don't get that yet. You need a population of 1700 before you get a boiler station, so you can start supplying hot water to your town. Only once looting for Oshi. I know, I saw it, dude. I was there. I watched the whole thing. Right, we get that in there. So water, and how much power have we got? Damn, we're down on power. So we need to get another wind turbine in. I'm going to go, there's a lot of wind power in this area, so I'm going to go for mainly wind power, actually. Let's get a couple in here. Have I got enough money for two? No. We'll just go with one. That's more than enough for now as well. So that's good. Yeah, there's a lot of wind through the valley. I don't know if I can see that yet. Yeah. So you can see, look, here's the wind. So we've got some good space up on the hill here to the side. But as you can see, out in the water, okay, we've got some really, really good wind power down here across the water. So once we can get the advanced wind turbine, you can potentially unlock this next grid nearby. Yay! Okay, there we go, first one. Little Hamlet, reached a population of 280. We can now do taxes, loans, garbage, healthcare, education, and other things. Now, the other interesting thing, with some of the mods that I have, it may assist the population mod. The population mod may assist because things like farms and industry don't require so many workers as they may do normally, which means that when things change around, forestry as well, when things change around, you may not see, like we were having before, like those catastrophic drops in workers and so on and so on. Right, it means we can throw some new stuff in here. We've got 29k. People are going to start demanding garbage services soon. Again, a little bit tricksy for me to where I want to actually place that, but I think I can get away with like putting it up here, and then it's, or even perhaps here, but then it's kind of far away from the services. One good thing is that I can, from the very word go, yeah, we'll put it up on the hill here, look, and then they can serve both sides when we actually get to that point, I think. So let's just put a little road in. Let's put a little road in here. Yeah. Let's put a little road in here that goes like this. And then we'll branch it up across here. Like that. Yeah, and then we'll get some garbage service. So let's bang that in. It's too steep. So it's going to have to be there. Okay. So that will start off. Now, one good thing that I can do is, I don't know if I can actually set nighttime stuff. Yes, I can. So I'm going to put garbage collection at the night time, so we're going to put that right down to like there, and we'll leave the garbage at 100% during night time. So this means that they basically should do more garbage pickups at night. This is beneficial because what it means is that because they will do garbage pickups at night, okay, instead of in the daytime, it means that they won't have to deal with all the traffic that you have in the daytime. That means that they should be able to more efficiently pick up garbage from around the town. So we'll see whether that's the case. They need to be a little bit careful coming down here because it's a bit slippy. Let's take a little look at our town as we come in. Oh, this happens to me every time. Every time I click on my vehicles, and I always forget that if I click off the screen too much. There we go. He's moving along collection. This is a nice little start. See, and now they won't be obstructed by all the vehicles and things. I love the detailing on the vehicles with the snow, where you can see like all the ice and stuff. Oh look, there's one of the new models. So I said I'd added in like loads of new models and things for the game, and this is one of them. We've now got Cadillacs, so there'll be little Cadillacs moving around, and there'll be some other new kinds of buildings and things that I can build. And they're still building new homes over here, which is good. But also, like I was saying about the population and how that is different. So if we check on this house right here, it's actually 0 of 3 households in this one, even though it says people in there. Okay, so this one, the middle residence, only 2 adults. So again, instead of seeing like loads and loads of people in these houses, there's actually less. Again, look in this one, they got 4 adults and 3 children and 2 teens. So obviously that's a bit of a, that seems unlikely, but maybe they've got a bit of a family thing going on there. This one here, there's actually 2 and 4 adults, so it's split into 2. So again, we're seeing sort of less people present. It makes it harder for you. It increases the difficulty because, you know, we need to get more people, we need to have more space, more people. You really need to get those high-rise blocks and things. So there we go. How much does Snowfall DLC cost? I don't know, it's like £10? Somebody can look it up on Steam for me. It's not very much, it's well worth the money. Skylines in general has been so much value for money that I have barely even thought about purchase, you know, I barely even considered whether I was worth it to make the purchase. As soon as I saw it come out, I was just like, buy, you know, and that's like pretty unusual in this day and age, you know, it's pretty unusual to be so confident of a purchase. But literally, as soon as I saw them, I was like, buy now. It's really nice, Azadi, it's really nice to see brand new subs in the chat with that LT icon. It makes all the difference, I swear. It's good. Let's get some shops down this side of town as well. We don't want to monopolize it all on one side of town. We'll start building. We've got more residential demand, so we'll get some more residential in here. Now, those residents are going to need a school pretty soon. I think we can start building some roads out this way as well. But the landscape is going to slightly dictate where these roads go. We'll roll a road down this way like this, but we won't necessarily build anything on it just yet. Here we go, we get some looting roads happening. Oh, we're getting power loss again. Power. We've got 20k, so that's alright. We get some more wind power in here. We need to get an 8 megawatts of power in. There we go. Strider says, I have the game, just wondering if I should get the DLC. I would. I would get all of the DLC. I think they're well. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so what is this? What does this snow icon? Does that mean the roads are, like, over-snowed? Oh, man. So much subs and so much donation to that, guys. I really appreciate it. TC Roberts, a small loan to go towards some more classic loot 11 raids. Thank you very much, TC Roberts. Too much emotes in the donation thing. I haven't seen this before. What does this mean? I'm assuming it just means it's frozen. I haven't seen any kind of like tutorial. It's like minus 15. So I guess they need more heating or something like this. But it's like the roads are frozen. The roads are frozen up. So like, how do we resolve that? I haven't really bothered to, by the way, research too much, so if anybody does know. But I'm curious, right, we're going to start with this. We'll have the Warunga Elementary School, which is always really good for the town. We place it right in here, and everybody is happy. Yeah, you shouldn't see those issues that we have seen in the past, where people get educated and that is detrimental. It should be that people more evenly go around jobs and that education is a good thing. And that's, again, to do with the population mods. Clear them roads. How do you clear the roads? Yeah, they're clearly snowed, so we need to get snow plows. But do we have those services? Yeah, you need a lot of salt for those roads. I assume that we need, like, some snow services or something to clear the roads, but I don't know what we will use to clear the roads, because I haven't seen anything so far that would allow me to clear the roads. So I'm curious. I know that there are some specific buildings and so on for this. Road menu. Oh, it's in the road menu. Okay, that's good to know. Ah! A snow dump. The snow dump sends out snow plows to clear streets of snow. When a snow plow has a full load of snow, turn to the snow dump to empty the load. Snow is melted at the dump to make more room for the snow. This is what we need. Okay, let's put this. It creates a lot of noise, as you can see. Let's put it down here. Okay, so put a snow dump. There we go. We're learning and playing. We're learning and playing. Okay, and again, I assume we can adjust that so that the snow plows and stuff are working. Here we go. Yeah, roads. Adjust the budget to decide how many vehicles road maintenance and snow dump vehicles have at their disposal. Well, we'll put most of it at night. We'll drop some of it off in the daytime. And we'll add a little bit. We'll add like 25% at night. So there we are. We'll drop it like by 25% in the day so that we can make sure they keep working in the day. We'll add that 25% onto the night shift. So they send out a few more at night time. But that's pretty cool. That is a brand new thing. Look, here we are. We can see them. Look, plowing. Clearing those roads. That is a great new mechanic. I love it. Really, really, really good. Oh my god. Fuse bots on the rampage yet again. This is cool though. That is a great new thing. Loving it. He's kind of clearing. He was right in front of a non-snow road there. He's kind of. I suppose maybe he's salting and gritting at the same time. Come on, buddy, you need to go up the road here. Turn left. Left! Oh, for fuck's sake. He's going all over the place. He's going wherever he wants to. Another new thing that I added. If it's working. Yeah. So this. So this is basically the road customizer tool. And I'll just show you really quickly the way that this works. So basically, in the past, we were able to turn lanes on and off and change them around. So basically, the way it works is, you can see right now, if I click on that button, and I come to a road like this, and I click on the central point, it then gives me these little icons, okay? So what I would do is, this road right here, if I want it to be only left and only right turn, what I'll do is I click, and I put one like this, and I put one like this, and then I right click, and now that is set. They now know he was already on a path. That's important to know, guys, when you do these changes. Any vehicles that are already set on a path will continue to go on them. And then that is now set to be only left and right turn. Okay, so see that car? Look, it's turning left. That car's turning right. But again, if I want to go back in and I want to edit that, I can edit it still. I can just click that off, or I can, hold on, I can click on this and I can again adjust it back like that. Okay, and then it'll have the straight on as well. So, however you want to change it, it will work. So that's really, really useful. Luton, I'm going to need a snowplow to be named Mr. Plow before the night is over, or I'll be very sad. Okay, we'll have this one right here. Okay, we'll do proper like Mr. We should also have the Plow King, I guess, as well. Okay, Mr. Plow is returning to facility. We need another one. Okay, here we go. We'll have this one right here. He can be... the Plow King. That name again, it's Mr. Plow. Workshop traffic version 2, if wondering, it makes your game slow. Traffic plus plus can be a really big problem for performance later in the game. But you know what? We'll worry about that when we come to it. You need road maintenance also for potholes. Really? We can't unlock that until we have a population of 3,400 anyway, so we have a little ways to go. Right, let's speed on. We need more residential. Let's get more residential in. Let's build some more roads. Keep expanding the city. I actually think I'm just going to leave that as it is. And we can get some nice residential areas going right down the backside here. So we're getting our nice little town. It's all coming together. But they are craving residential right now. And we're going to have to start expanding the town, really. But I don't want to cross... Man, this is really a blizzard right now. Look at it. Absolute blizzard. Whoa. Okay, Jesus. That caught me out right there. Worthy Village. 600. Reach population. We've got all districts policies, second loans, service policies, police department, unique buildings, and specializations, etc. Smoke distributors for these things. And we've got firehouses, police stations, and so on. Can I get one called Plowing Your Mum? For God's sake. Seriously. Not that kind of stream. Snow DLC turned this into Canada Simulator. we still need more residential. Let's keep expanding, expanding. We'll just plot it all into this one area for now so that if we need to... excuse me, upgrade our services in this area we can. So we'll just keep pushing forward there. We're going to need stuff like medical centers and healthcare stuff. So let's... But money, money, money. We can use our Cleekerson's healthcare center, which will be enough to get us started there. It's cheaper. It makes everything work good. Fire stations. They're so spread apart right now. It's a bit questionable whether we're better off to go 272, 560. Yeah, it's about as long as it is short, really. So probably what I'm going to do is I'm going to bang in... But see, this thing really doesn't cover very much. But neither does that one, to be fair. I'm going to bang in a fire station right there. And I'm going to get another one over, like, here. There we go. These things are always stuff to kind of keep people coming in. Oh my god, Yaris, the icon chat spam is unbearable. Right? Just trying, so much chat tonight, I was just checking with the chat that we're not missing too much. Right, we need more electricity yet again. We are really... This is a big change-up, actually, that... it's actually quite hard right now that we're requiring a lot more electricity than we ordinarily would, and it's because people just need so much more electricity for heating and stuff. Also, the population is... you know, we have to build a lot more areas in order to keep the kind of population ticking over. So there's a lot that's changing with this, actually. And plus, I've made it more difficult for myself with the population mod. So we actually just have to have more people. So it's kind of doubly difficult. I wonder whether... We'll see what happens, but I start to wonder whether I maybe have made it too difficult for myself. But we'll see how that goes. It's a possibility. It's a possibility, because with the population mod... You know, because there are less people in each building, that means you need more houses, more residences to bring in the same amount of income, etc., right? So although you have a realistic amount of people staying in the city, it just means that, you know, you're not going to be getting so much, which means that, like, right now, my weekly income is really, really low, whereas by now it would normally be pretty good. So this is a problem for me. It's going to be interesting to see just kind of how that works. Putting some more water pipes in. There we go. That's covered that. So we are making some money. I suppose actually one thing that I haven't done right now is adjust my taxes. So I'll bang these up to 11 on everything. That's going to bring us in plenty more money, obviously. I'll put the industrial on 12 just for fun. Right, that's straight away going to bring us in a lot more money. But we'll see. These guys complaining about power. We can't be out of power already. Jesus Christ. Ugh. Tiny town, population of 9. It's a tiny town. High school and things. We're rolling through some of this new stuff. We have got money now to build more power, but we really need to get this advanced wind turbine happening. I'm starting to wonder whether I should build a coal plant. But it does create massive pollution, but it also brings in quite a lot of electricity. I think it's worth it though initially, because we are craving power. So I'm going to put a coal power plant in here. There we go. It's far away from town, and we have, you know, we're trying our best. We've got some wind power, but at the same time, you know, can't do it all the way. I love the way you say water, Luton. It's just, I said in just a normal way. We've got some criminals. The Dean residents. What are they up to? They are misbehaving. American pronunciation of water pisses me off. I can't even think of how that is. Water. I can't imagine in my mind like how they would say that. Let's get police in. Oh, we can't afford police. Oh. We couldn't nearly afford police. God, the police stations are really expensive. The local police rural station is 6k. Let's bang that in for now. Stop those pesky crimos. Everything does look cool with sort of snow in there. But we're doing a good job keeping everything working right now. Okay, so we should really start naming the first town, guys. So if you would like the town to be named after you, please tell me why. Tell me in the chat why, guys, and I will get the... There's two districts we're going to have. We're going to have the first residential district. Oh, look, we're not keeping that road clear out here. That's a good point, see, that we're going to have issues here. I wonder if I can upgrade this road to a highway now. Still can't do highway. Need population 1700. Can they actually get across that bit? Oh, they can. They just kind of slow down. That's bad, though, that that's filling up with snow right there. Right, anyway, let's see this. Fusuria. That's a terrible name. It can't be a crap name as well. Like, make some effort, seriously. If you want the district named after you, it has to be, like, actually half good. It can't just be a rubbish name. God, it's so white. Look at the district because of the snow. It's, like, reflecting it so much. Yeah, it can't be a terrible name for the district because it's, like, this is the starting district. This is the first district in the whole of the town, right? So it's got to be good. Can't just be rubbish. I take pride in my names. I know you lot like to have a laugh, but I like it to be good. Well, that's the first one in. Let's do the other area first before we start worrying about naming. Let's do that one more simply. Right, there we are. So we've got two districts to begin. Okay. I'm going to now look at your suggestions and see what's what. Hi, right, okay, subs. Confluence. Two rivers joining together. It's a confluence. Not bad. I actually quite like the type, the name of, you know, confluence. That's quite a good town name. Okay, let's look. Darthville. Darthville, you gotta have some imagination, seriously. Ah, don't go there, Liam. Too much controversy. Liamville. Come on, guys, use your imaginations, please. Jack from Stake, Greener Pastures, Confluential District, White Plains. That's not bad. That's a nice little sort of title. I am actually just going to go with, I quite like Confluence. Fuse is saying because I'm Fuse and I'm one of the longest subs. That's not how it works, Fuse. We're not in like a, it's not pay to play, it's not pay to win. I'm just going to go with Confluence. I actually like that as a name for the town. Yeah, there we go. Confluence. Okay, so it's the town of Confluence. But over here we've got Sunnyside Heights, which I think I will go with Fuse for this, because Fuse had like the farm last time. Confluence sounds like a real name too. Yeah, exactly, exactly. Flame Town. Man, you guys don't just take your name and then add town or ville to your name. That's super super uninspiring. Riverside Cliffs. See, that's a nice name. I think we will go with Fuse for this, though. What can we go with, though? We'll have... Fuse is what? The Democratic People's Farm of Fusoria. No, because it's... that's not appropriate. I think we'll just have, like, Fuse's Workhouse down here. Fuse's Workhouses. Because it's kind of like, you know, it's just a horrible place to go. Fuse's Workhouses down in the corner. Because there are more, there's more sort of, like, shacks and buildings than there are, like, factories. We've got one big factory here, Dino Oil. Look at how smoggy it is. Look at the amount of smog. I can barely even see through it. It's so depressing, like there's so much smog. I guess it's all coming from the coal plant right here. Just ridiculous. Look at that haze hanging over it. Horrible. Oh my god, there's a blaze. There's a blaze at the ice cream factory. whenever the ice cream places catch fire, it does just make me think of IT Crowd and the fire at the sea parks. It's just really funny. Fuses dodgy wares, didn't we? No, because we had some famous London fog. Yeah, it is a little bit. That ice cream on fire. Yeah, I know. Okay, we have still extremely minimal income coming in, but let's see if we can't change that by bringing more residences. So we've got to get more people in here. The money management so far is being the most difficult thing, and I think it's just going to continue to be because, kind of as I said, we have to provide a lot more for people, but at the same time, it's quite tricky, right? We don't want to build any further this way. Maybe we can get one shop in there. Right, we're going to have to build in other directions now, which is going to be tricky for us. We could build like a tunnel going up here, but I think honestly what we're going to have to do is sort of build across this way. How much money? We still don't have a lot of money, and there's still things we need. Like we've got one, we've got a couple of fire departments, we've got a small police station, etc. But I've got to keep an eye on my power. My power is good right now. Water is good right now. Garbage usage is fine, but we have like other things that we need. Fire safety. Still can't build heating stuff yet. We're on the way to that. Set taxes to 12% and let them deal. Well, we could do. They don't like 12% taxes on residential, but we could try and do that. They'll freak out, but we'll put it to 12 and just see whether people start immediately freaking out about this. A little bit of upgrading. We could get some parks in. Parks are like more cost. We can put a park here on this corner. And then, let's do that actually. Let's get a park in somewhere. We'll just start with my small little park, because it's very good for kind of, and it fits right on these corners nicely. We'll just bang that in. There we are, like instant happiness. Instant home upgrading. Yep, people are loving it, loving it, loving it. And that will in itself bring us some more income in there by putting that in there. Okay, so we've got our park. Trouble is going to the park, it's going to be like, look at it, they've got ceramic tiles. It's going to be an absolute ice death trap. But this is nice, the town is looking nice, and already starting to get some real feel for this one. But it'll all develop as it goes along. That's always the key to these, is that they sort of, you know, as we push forward, it really develops. But it's got a nice little towny feel, and this is good. We're going to head towards, can we actually unlock our, yeah, we've got a new grid square already. I think I'm going to go for the one to the north. Because then we can push out along this way. But how much is it going to cost us? 3 grand. I think it's worth it. Gives us access to some new things as well. Right, so that's our first grid square. So that's going to be beneficial for us because now I can branch roads right across here that can go all the way around. So we can really, like, just with this, and look, we've got access to this whole area now. So you can see some of the stuff that you're going to have access to on this map. And as I say, I'll try and post this on the Steam Workshop really soon. For extra income, use the policy small business boost, whatever it's called. Cost you some, overall it's worth it. Yeah, that's a good point, actually. We should actually put some policies in by now. I don't think we can use that one yet, though. Yeah, we don't have the taxation thing, but you always will put that policy on later. There's parks and rec and smart ban and blah, blah, blah. There's no kind of actual policies that we want to put in place right now, because, yeah, there's just... You know, we need to unlock more, basically. They seem to be taking that 12% tax on the nose. They seem to be quite happy about it. It's making me think I can put 12 on the commercial as well. Everybody's houses are still upgrading, though, so that's good. We've got some good money coming in now. So we can start pushing upgrades on the town. We're going to have to start considering about expanding the roads. There's a lot of traffic coming in here right now. So we're going to have to start thinking about that. I want a town on the ridge. The area seems ideal for logging. Not just logging, but also you can see here, we have a nice oil-rich area up here. So down through the valley, when the, you know, the glaciers have come through and pushed this all away, we've actually got some oil resources here. We also have ore. We have a lot of ore up here in the hills. So this is, again, it's really helpful to have this right next to the starting area. We do have some farm area, but I don't know how well farming is going to really work in this sort of winterscape, you know. But we can get some oil industry happening up here, and we can also get some ore industry, a lot of ore industry actually. So that'll probably be where I aim to get to for the start this evening. I'm going to aim to get to creating us some good industries right there. Oil rich in the middle of a forest, get those trees down. Okay, let's keep building. We need more industry right now. People want more industry. So let's actually push this up. Actually, we could already get up into those hills, maybe. That's going to be a pretty extreme road up there, though. How would we ideally get up there? We'd sort of climb up the hill. Maybe we could. How much money have we got? We've got 17k in the bank. We could do this. I'm getting the RA mod on. Yeah, do you know what? The hell with it. Let's do it. Let's get some industry right up here. We'll start as we mean to go on, and we'll get some loot and roads happening. I'm going to save before I screw everything up. So we're going to start. What is going to be the name? Oh yeah, we need to actually name... Okay, guys, here we go. This is more important than anything else. More important than anything else. We need to come up with a name for the city. Okay. So right now it's called Lakewood. This will be the name for the whole... This is the name for the whole of everything, okay? So this will be the name for the entire playthrough. Last time we had Feathered Stones. Okay? Before that we had Granite Shores. So, guys in the stream, come up with the name that you think is going to be really good for this entire playthrough. Okay. This actual valley is called Callow Ridge. That's the name of the map. That doesn't have to be the name of the city. Also, notice this. Up here, guys, there's a really huge plain area. This is perfect for a great big city. You can get a big city up on here. So, again, I've put a lot of thought into where you could put little communities down through the valleys. So, even though the landscape is quite dramatic, it suits actually building around it. God, so much spam. Strider, if you don't stop spamming me in Whisper, I'm going to turn Whisper off for right now. White Springs, Nelson Bay, that's not bad. Oh god, ching 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 ching, bloody ching ching. Liam, can I get an ore mine called Liam? No. Liam's Deep Penetration. No. No. This is family streaming right here. Family. We're building nice little towns. You guys are taking it right down every time. Ice Hills, Winterhold, Windheim. Somebody's going to be original here. Snowcroft Ridge, Missouyaka, Pine Ridge, not too bad. Frozen Rivers, Pine Ridge, Snowy Cliffs. We're going to keep on playing until you guys come up with something good. It took a while last time as well, I remember. These are all very, like, kind of obvious. Please go the long way around looting, don't do anything too extreme. What with my road building? My road building is never extreme. What are you talking about? Lake Effect Valley, Drift Woods, River Highlands. No, think about it. It has to be descriptive. Descriptive. So like last time we had Feathered Stones. That was a nice, kind of really good descriptive name. River Wood. It's like, it's too kind of like, it's too obvious to just your surrounding area. You should try and think of something like a little bit more outside the box, I think. Right, whilst you guys are thinking about that, I'm going to build this. Right, so I reckon if I come, like, up here, I need to kind of come back on myself almost. Or maybe we can, like, and then tunnel through here or something. This could work. Cracked Ice Valley. Still not impressing me. Winterfell, Twilight Valley, Powdered Oaks. Hmm. Quite like Powdered Oaks. Hmm. Powdered Oaks, Arendale. Arendale, I quite like the sound of. Crystal Breeze Valley, Slander Valley. Cocaine on the Floor Town. Capricorn Hill. Hmm, that's quite nice. I'm still preferring, like, Arendale or... Powdered Oaks. Powdered Oaks is nice. The only trouble with Powdered Oaks is there are no oak trees. And I said it's got to be like not too literal, but that's kind of like too much. Soylent Wipe, Glacial Shores. I don't know. Powdered Pines, maybe. Powdered Pines. Yeah, let's do that. Snow Pine. I'm going to go with Powdered Pines. Although you would never have a town named Powdered Pines. You'd never call your city Powdered anything. You'd never, like, everyone is, like, using two words in their town names. That's true, actually. It doesn't always have to be two words. Because most town areas are not two words. Let's just roll on for a little bit and see whether we can come up with anything better. Because it's going to be the name of the whole thing, you see. Right, let's just start this road here. So, we're going to bang it round. Let's get ready to rumble. Let's get ready to hilltop climb. These roads are going to wish they were never born. Right, so we will begin getting up here. And then we need to This is some good LT building. So I really need to curve it right around like that, almost, but as you can see, the road doesn't want to do that. I have to be kind of a little bit sort of careful with how I build this. It's not bending as much as I would like, actually. It's going to be quite tricky to get up and around this one. There we go. Need to get a bit of height on this. Kind of has to look kind of realistic how it's going up there as well. Is that going to actually intersect that? If I go like this, is that going to actually intersect that? I don't know. I'm trying to just figure this out here. Oh no, it's okay. Jesus. I've got the Road Anarchy mod on, which enables me to build kind of like a little bit more extreme, but at the same time you've got to be kind of sensible with it, because it can't be too extreme, otherwise that would be just silly. Oh, that's not too bad though. But that's bang on perfect. Oh, actually no, it is quite extreme. But it's... that may be too extreme. It's like the road, the cars will actually still drive on that, but it's like a little bit too much. Right, let's see how your ideas are coming, guys. Snow Pine Valley. That's yeah, not too bad. A little bit sort of straightforward. Ooh, Silver Ridge. That's quite nice. Ancra, it's a valley in Latin. Pine Dale. Snowside Valley. Chicken with that, damn, you've gained many viewers. Keep it up. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, we do get a good amount of viewers here. If you're new, guys, and you want to see more of this stuff every week, and you want to see me stream other games as well, and talk about games and play things and do all sorts of discussive stuff, hit that follow, guys, and join me every time I stream. It can't be too extreme, because that would be silly, looting 2016. I know. Where's the OCD when you want it? Where are you guys, like, you guys missing the emotes? All you subs are missing out on emote times, emote opportunities. Right, okay, let's just... See, it's going to be... However I do this, it's like... I need to kind of just gradually ease it around. Or we do, like, a switchback like that. Because you do have, like, some extreme bends and stuff. How much is that going to be? Not too much. No matter how I do this, it's like... will not behave. You can just literally switch it back on a right angle right here. Yes, OCD. White water. Not bad, Flame. Silver bluff. Bluffs. Silver bluffs. Silver bluffs. Silver bluffs. That's it. Silver bluffs. And the reason... Oh, oh, Thunder Bluff. The reason I was thinking of Silver Bluffs and Thunder Bluff is because... in World of Warcraft, I played a Tauren character, and the home city of Tauren's is Thunderbluff, and kind of really makes me want to do that. Chicken says, dude, that's shite. No, it's not. I actually like it a lot. Because, as I say, for that reason, with World of Warcraft, it actually gives it a little collection for me, which is quite nice. That's me done. Have a good night, everyone. Thanks, as always, Luton. Catch up on the rest of the uploads. Yeah, they'll all be on YouTube. Thanks, Wet Paint. See you next time. Pine Bluffs or Silver Bluffs? I don't know. I think silver, because the map is very silvery. Thunder Snow. No. Yeah, Silver Bluffs. I don't know. We need to sit with it. Don't make a snap decision, ever. Right, let's keep building this road. I'm going to let money sort of trickle in whilst we're building. I'm just trying to decide whether I can get away with this. Or we could, like, loop it back around and over itself. That would be good. I'm just like... Yeah, that's fine. They'll just have to be careful on the corner is all. Right, okay. Let's just bang this through here. And we'll tunnel through that, if it will let us anyway. Wait, why is it not letting me tunnel through? There we go. Tunneling. It's been expensive though, look, 8 grand. Yeah, I'm not sure about that. I really wanted to start the, yeah, like the tunneling higher up, like, just bang it through there. We'll just raise it up on here, it's fine. And that's going to be an extreme drop that they've got to go down there. Definitely put the brakes on when they get down that part. They're going to like have very... imagine when that road gets icy. I know, right? This area that this road is leading to should be named Thunder Ridge. Yeah, I think so, maybe. Feathered Stones 2? No. No, absolutely not. I'm still looking through. Ivory Bluffs? No. Kiruna. Eagle Peaks. What you guys should be doing, really, is looking on maps for names of towns and stuff that are in actual ridgeline areas. That would be the real sort of way to go about this. I'm not sure that that Road Anarchy mod actually helps me that much, because... it's sort of, it doesn't enable, when you have Road Anarchy on, it doesn't do stuff like this. It doesn't, it's useful sometimes, but it doesn't enable you to do like nice little sweep arounds and things like that. But it does enable you to go up kind of like insane surfaces and stuff. But, you know, like that will be possible with Road Anarchy, but it's not with the other ones. But that is actually what I need to do to get up here. It's going to be questionable as we sort of bang it back around like that. There needs to be like a lot of right angled, but you see, like when you're doing actual like mountain climbing road, this is kind of generally how it goes. Jesus, man, that's a slope you want to be careful coming down there. Let me tell you right now. And then see, we can just go up here like this. Should be fine. We made it. We made it to the top. Okay, now all we've got to do is just actually get up here. Is that going to bend around properly? Yes. A little bit of destruction of the ground, but we've made it. Made it to the top. Beautiful. There we go. We are here. I think I'm actually still above ground. There we are. I should be on zero, actually. Let me just delete that. A little too high on the road. It should be zero. Like that. There we go. We made it. We're at the top. Good luck, drivers. Good luck, ore drivers, going down this road. That's going to be the question point right there. Oh my god. This should be called like Death Road Valley or something. I did suggest Banff, which is a really nice mountain city in Canada. It's a little short. Cold Oak, Breckenridge, Chestnut Ridge. Base. Coal Rain, the place I live in real life. It's not bad. Luton is going to be mass murder. I don't know, I don't think so. I think it's going to be fine. We just need to build a new area up here. Note me saying I think it's going to be fine. Right, we should have our industry. Oh, we haven't got ore yet. That's the only trouble. We need to get 1700, so that's like our ore industry prepared. But we do need some more of yeah, there's a lot of people freaking out because of jobs and stuff right now. Let me just put some more into Fuse's workhouse. Horrible place, nobody wants to work here. Right, we'll bang in a few more and they'll immediately start to work. Right, we've been sort of neglecting our town a little bit, but we'll work back to it a bit more now. Yeah, like, see, people are leaving, they're like, oh, you suck, Luton, everything's terrible. I know. Right, we should get in, we haven't got a graveyard or anything yet either, so we should definitely put a Cleekerson's graveyard in. And actually bang it right here. There we go. Graveyards and things also, they also benefit from doing everything at night time. So that can be good. We need to get some more pipes in here. that. We're going to need to expand our industry as we go here. What is the 11-10 emote meaning? Well, it's 11 out of 10. It's better than 10 out of 10. It's like, you know, the best. It's good. Pike's Peak is good. Yeah, it's too kind of well known, though. TC Ridge. Pike's Peak. Yeah, those roads. I do feel bad for the guys who are going to have to drive up here. It's going to be really awful for them, but they'll make it. They'll bring the ore in. Onion Town. You're not trying today, Flame. You're not trying. Silverado, Groutville. I'm going to have to come up with a name myself. It's not sort of sitting well for me today. We need to get some more industry in still. I don't want to expand too much this way because I really need to get... So actually just build another little sort of industrial road going around the back here. I don't want to build too much this way because I still need to get wind turbines down, so I need to have enough space to actually put them in there. There we go. Get a little bit of industry in. Damn, there's literally just only demand for industry. We're not bringing in that many people either, and we really need to bring in more people. Oh yeah, Flame, you're right, Onion Town. Actually, if people... Yeah, now that you say it, I remember Flame. You know, Flame, if people knew that story, it might actually be appropriate. Jesus. The sound of industry kind of caught me off guard there. It's a bit scary. God, it's so much smog here. Look at it. It's a filth, filth place. Oh, we're doing fine. also, again, remembering that we're sort of... Our limited growth is down to probably, again, that population model a little bit there. It's going to take longer to grow different areas. Trondheim. I am aware of... I think that name, again, feels a bit too familiar. Kanto Plateau. I think, like, we've built this up too much now, and nothing's going to be good enough for anybody. I should just put into, like, you know, just city name generator into, like, Google or something. Right, we still need more industry, but I'm kind of resisting a little bit. What is the farming area like around here? A little bit of farming, not much. You know, we can build some little farms here. We don't need too much farming going on. So there's a little bit just here, like out of town. And we can probably make do with just like some dirt tracks off of this. I like having like little farms. I've kind of said this before. I like having the kind of more sort of casual farming style, where it's a bit more just kind of like, you know, more sort of like local farm rather than big industrial farm. I quite like that. Winterfield or Wintervale? What was Confluence like? Lutengrad? No. Too much controversy. Pine Top, Knotty Woods. No. Waikapu, Brian. Briarcliff. Quite like Briarcliff. Briarcliffs. Rockheim. I quite like the idea of Briarcliffs or Rockheim. I quite like both of those. Obviously, the trouble as well, when you're doing a name, like, you can't please everybody. People are always going to be pissed off with it, whatever. Like, I'll be like, oh, I love that. And everyone will be like, I hate that. Well, bad luck. It's my choice. Right, I'm just going to build a little farm area here. It's not going to be anything too massive. I don't quite understand how people are going to farm in this area, but I suppose rationale would be that maybe they sort of focus more on sort of greenhouse farming and just general farm products rather than actual field farming, but somehow I expect that won't be replicated when the actual farm stuff starts happening. Right, so let's put in a couple of little pieces just to begin with. We'll just put that. Oh, they've got water already. That's handy. Although we've had issues where farming doesn't start straight away. So is it? Oh, oh, it is. It is starting. Now, what are they going to build here? Surely not farms. Yeah. Look. See, this is. I'm okay with this. Sunny grain. Look. So they're building like little. But those look like fields, or something. I don't know what they are meant to be. Let's see. Look, some nice little greenhouses and things, and some sheds with wood and other bits and pieces. And there's some nice little sort of farmy things here. I'm okay with that. That's good. That makes sense. These kind of like polytunnel things or something. That seems like the kind of farming that you would have. So I'm okay with that. We'll just bang in a bit more because we've got a massive industrial demand right now. I need a new cup of tea, you know. That's what I need. Yeah, we've got some good money coming in and everything like this. Let's see. Blue Water Ridge. That's all right. Never melt. Lynn, how do you make farms? Where you just zone the district to agriculture and then you put down industry as normal and it will make farms and stuff. So you've got here, look, some nice little trees growing and things. But again, it's sort of, this actually helps having the, oh, that's one of my new things, look, guys. So I added this in, and this is a Scania milk tanker. So this is one of the new models that I placed into the game, and so that's one of the new mods. So he will be delivering and transporting milk to and from everywhere we need to go. That's good. Heading towards that 1700, but not quite enough just yet. Still need more industry coming in so that people can have enough jobs to do. Never melt. The icicle forest. I still like briar cliffs, but I don't think it's so much. I don't feel cliffs because I feel like cliffs are something you have at sea, and we don't have that. God, it's so hard, isn't it? Choosing a name is like the hardest. Boreal Drifts. That's quite nice. Choosing a name is incredibly difficult. Like, it's really, really hard. Like, sometimes when I've wanted to create, like, a new character for a game or something, and you sit there, and you just sit, thinking about it forever, and you can just never decide.